Just give somebody high five and tell them you are welcome into the presence of God. Shake somebody, this is God's house. Just shake somebody and make sure that your attention is here. And make sure you are not distracted by anything, because when you come to the house of God, you must give him the maximum respect that is due only unto him. Praise God. And so you may want to find a seat to sit down. Hallelujah. You may want to sit down and let every distraction cease. Let every distraction cease completely. And everybody find a place to sit. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
We live in exciting times where the glory of God is being made manifest in our lives. We are not a people that walk by sight, because we walk by faith. I see miracles about to happen in this end time.
Yes.
I see God about to recruit an end time militia man. Men that have been separated unto God for greater works. I see people that God is going to single out for exploits. In this end time, only people that are prepared are ready to stand in for God to use them to bring about a change. And may you be that candidate that God is looking for. I said, may you be that individual who is so hungry for God and hungry for the things of God. May God find you and anoint you with his holy oil. Oh, I feel like talking to somebody here. You see, and that's why when we come to God, it's not us, it is me. Because God is dealing with us individually. And the eyes of God are still running to and fro to show himself strong on the behalf of those whose hearts are perfect towards him. And any time God wants to do something in any dispensation, he's looking for a man. He's looking for a woman. He looks for only one person and then uses him to bring revival and a change. And I see you standing in the gap in this end time to declare, thus saith the Lord, and to bring about a change in the kingdom of God. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but I prophesy that somebody will stand ready for what God is about to do in this end time. If you believe it, shout amen. This hour I'm preaching on thy kingdom come.
Hallelujah.
Thy kingdom come. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And we know that it's a prayer when the disciples, one thing that thrills me is about the fact that when the disciples approached Jesus, they didn't ask him, teach us how to preach. They didn't come asking Jesus to teach them how to preach. But he said, teach us how to pray. Because effective preaching can only be backed by effective prayer. Am I talking to somebody here? In other words, they understood the secret of Jesus' success. They understood that there was something about Jesus that was unique, and it was his prayer life. They were not impressed by the preaching or whatever, but they saw something that made his preaching effective. They saw something that made his life effective. They saw something that caused the multitude to flock to him. And they understood that it was a secret of prayer. And so they came to Jesus and said, teach us how to pray. May we be a generation of praying Christians. Because any time I read church history and I read about the fathers who started revival in our lands, they were men of prayer. But today we are people of playing. We play church. We play religion. The only thing we don't do is pray. But may God raise a generation that will understand prayer. Because prayer is the force that moves the hand that moves the world. A man or a woman of prayer that understands prayer will never lack oil on their lives. May I prophesy over this church? May we rise up. Sometimes it might not be all of us, but there will be a passion, a growing passion in somebody's spirit for prayer. To pray endlessly until we see the glory of God come upon the church and upon God's people and upon this generation. May God raise a man. May God raise a woman. A woman who has a desire for prayer until we see the manifestation of the glory of God on our lands. Until we see people flocking to Jesus without any manipulation. Am I talking to somebody here? Until we see the glory and the reign of God upon the people of God. Until we begin to see tangible miracles where the sick is healed, cripples begin to walk, the blind begin to see. I prophesy over your life in the name of Jesus. May you become that candidate. Jesus, teach us how to pray. Teach us how to pray. If your prayer life is solid, your life will be solid. Because prayer activates the supernatural in your environment. And so they came at Jesus and teaching them how to pray. So when you pray, say, "Our Father who is in heaven." In Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 to 10, praise God. Jesus began to teach them how to pray. What Jesus was giving them was to, he gave them the format as to how to pray effectively. He says, pray this way: "Our Father who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." And that's where my preaching is based on. Your kingdom come. It says when you are praying, pray for the kingdom of God to come. Because if the kingdom of God comes, the will of God will be done on earth as it is done in heaven. Am I talking to somebody here? That means that all we need is the kingdom. Because if the kingdom comes, the will of God shall be done on earth as it is done in heaven. In heaven, there is no sickness. In heaven, there is no poverty. Am I talking to somebody here? And so if the kingdom comes, the will of God shall be done on earth as it is done in heaven. I prophesy in the name of Jesus over your life. May God open the eyes of understanding, because as soon as we begin to walk in the kingdom principles, everything will come into alignment with the will and the purpose of God for our lives, because the kingdom enforces the will of God in your life. If you are working by the dictates of the kingdom, the will of God shall be done in your life as it is done in heaven. Am I talking to somebody here? That means that the kingdom qualifies you to live in heaven on earth. That means when the kingdom comes, and in a minute I'm going to show you what this kingdom is all about. The arrival of the kingdom is the arrival of the will of God upon the earth. Should I talk to somebody? And so he says, when you pray, say, "Let your kingdom come." The kingdom is the rulership of God. The kingdom is the sovereignty of God. God must rule over territories. And I'm going to show you in a minute why Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Because in his rulership, his will is done. And if he's ruling, then there must be surrender to his rulership and to his authority and to his dominion. Am I talking to somebody here? And so if we can thrive in the atmosphere of his rulership and his sovereignty, that his will will be enforced upon our lives. I'm praying and prophesying today, as the eyes of your understanding is opened about the kingdom, you will begin to walk according to the will of God. here. The will of God is that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prosper. I see God coming your way with supernatural visitation. I see God opening doors that men cannot open. I feel like I'm sorry, because in the kingdom of God, all things are possible. Healing is possible. Deliverance is possible. Power is possible. I see God lifting you from one level to another level. Hiya! Come on, somebody, lift up your hands. Give the Lord a shout. Pray. Let your kingdom come.
Yes.
I was reading the Bible in the book of Matthew, chapter 44 to 46. It says, the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field. Somebody say kingdom. No, tap somebody and say kingdom. I am praying that you understand the principles of the kingdom. Because the principles of the kingdom does not work like the principles of the kingdom of the world. We are talking about the kingdom of God. And says, the Bible says the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure. Somebody says treasure. Hidden in a field, which a man found and hid it. And for the joy over it, he goes and sells all that he has just to buy that field. And so here Jesus is saying that the kingdom of God is like a treasure that a man finds. And when he has found a treasure in the field, he decided to hide it. And then he went and sold everything he had to buy the land. The reason he was buying the land was because of the treasure. That is how the kingdom of God is. So the kingdom of God is like a treasure. So if you understand the kingdom of God, you will know that you are treasured. That means that material wealth in the world cannot be compared with what is pertained in the kingdom. I feel like talking to somebody here. Now when you became born again, listen to me, and I'm talking about the kingdom of God. When you became born again and you gave your life to Jesus, and Jesus became the Lord of your life, you entered into the kingdom of God.
Yes.
That's why the Bible says, don't look for observation that will characterize the arrival of the kingdom, for the kingdom of God is within you. The rulership of God, that means as a born again believer, I am in the kingdom of God, because where there is a kingdom, there must be a territory, and there must be a king who rules over the territory, and there must be subjects who obey the king. And so as a child of God, the Bible says we have been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God. And so when I gave my life to Jesus, I feel like talking to somebody here, there was a paradigm shift. God shifted me from the kingdom and the domain and the authority and the oppression and depression of the enemy. And he translated me, transported me into the kingdom of Jesus Christ. That's why I'm the head and not the tail. That's why I'm above and not beneath. That's why no weapon formed and fashioned against me shall prosper. That's why a thousand shall fall on my left and thousand on my right. It shall not come near me, but with my eyes I shall behold the reward of the wicked. That's why my story is different from your story. That's why you may go down, but I will never go down, because Jehovah is the lifter up of my head. Because I don't belong to the kingdom of darkness, I belong to the kingdom of Jesus, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I feel like talking to somebody here. I feel like prophesying over somebody's life, because I see the rulership of God enforcing the kingdom and the will of God in your life. Is a treasure. That's why I don't take for granted my experience of salvation. Is a treasure. It's worth more than what the world can offer you. And some of us, that is a secret we don't understand. When this guy found the treasure in the field, he sold everything he had That means nothing in this world can be compared with the experience I have. You may be a prime minister in this world, but in the kingdom of God, the least in the kingdom of God is greater than the greatest in the world. I feel like talking to somebody here. Oh, come on, somebody, slap somebody and say, I have a treasure in the kingdom. And it says again, the kingdom of God is like a merchant seeking beautiful pearls. Who, when he has found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that he had and bought it. Kingdom. Somebody say kingdom.
Kingdom.
As soon as you begin to walk with kingdom mindedness, it changes everything about your life. The reason sometimes people will do things in the house of God and it looks as though they are crazy is because they understand kingdom. Praise God. If you don't understand kingdom, you pursue material things. But when you come to understand kingdom, you use material things to advance God's kingdom. And it's a thing that God will turn around to lift you so high. Yeah. Kingdom. Let your kingdom come. Because if we recognize God's kingdom and begin to walk, submit to the authority of the king, because he has made us kings and priests. How many of you have read that in the book of Revelation chapter 1 verse 6? The Bible says God has made you kings, he's made you priests. Okay, the reason he is the king of kings is because he rules over kings. Oh, you don't understand it. He is a king over kings. That means you are a king. But there is a king of kings who rules over kings. I feel like talking to somebody here. And that portion of scripture is not talking about women. It's talking about you as a king. You as a lord. He rules over us. And when the eyes of your understanding is opened, you begin to walk under the covering of the sovereignty of Yahweh. When the eyes of your understanding begins to open for you to know who you are, where you are placed in God's kingdom, it changes everything about your life. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, because the will of God can only be done in his kingdom. That's why sometimes some things don't make sense to the world. Am I talking to somebody here? Because some things that pertain to the kingdom of God is not applicable, it's nonsensical to the world, it's foolishness to the world. But in the kingdom, we do not operate by the principles of the world, we operate by the principles of the kingdom. That's why it says, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I'm rich. So I can come without any money in my pocket, but I'm so loaded because I'm a treasure in the kingdom of God. I feel like talking to somebody here. I came here with a prophetic voice in my mouth to declare to somebody from today, as the eyes of your understanding is open, you begin to walk under the rulership and the sovereignty and the order of heaven. Your life will not be patterned according to the economy of this world, but your life shall be structured and patterned according to the kingdom of God. That's why he says, and I will supply all of your needs according to the riches of God in Christ Jesus. I prophesy over your life, may the resources of the kingdom come upon you abundantly. Because if the kingdom comes, his will be done on earth as it is done in heaven. That's why we must pray for God to establish his kingdom in the hearts of man. Because if the kingdom is established, the will of God will be done. And I was looking at the scripture. Your will be done on earth as it is done in heaven. I don't know about you, but I began to claim it. Amen. In this kingdom.
Amen.
Where Jesus is the king and I'm the subject. Every kingdom has rules and laws and obligations. But It is a responsibility of every king within the kingdom to supply the needs of the subjects within the kingdom. That's why in the United Kingdom, even when you are not working, the queen makes sure that something comes into your accounts. Now, if man can supply your needs in his kingdom, how much more the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? He will make a way where there seems to be no way. When people have rejected you, he will be there for you. Prophesy over your life in the name of Jesus. I see resources coming into your bank accounts. I see money knocking at your door. I see God lifting you from one level to another level. Come scream and shout and say, I receive it. His will, because in heaven there's no lack. I feel like I'm talking to somebody here. In heaven, do you know why there's no lack? There's no lack because the angels in the heavenly kingdom are subject to the king. And every day, they are before him, worshiping the king. I feel like talking to somebody here. There is no lack in heaven because the glory of God has saturated heaven so much so that lack cannot survive in that environment. May sickness never survive in your environment. May poverty never survive. In the kingdom of God, where there is worship and there is honor and there is service, the glory of God saturates the environment so much so that the devil cannot come near the glory. Because in the kingdom, yes, the will of God is enforced.
Amen. Preach it.
In the kingdom where the subjects are submitted to the king, the angels, that's what they do, worship. They don't worship him only when things are good. They don't even know the difference. They are called to worship. That's why when we go to heaven, we'll go into that perfect state where it will be worship all the time.
Oh, yes.
And that's why even when we come here and it's time for worship and some of you are walking around, sometimes I feel like, if only they understood the angels of God that are surrounded here. Sometimes you come to this place and you don't understand that the angels of God encamp around the righteous. And anytime we lift up worship unto God, angels are deployed. I feel like talking to somebody here to worship with us. I feel like talking to somebody here. I prophesy in your worship, may God release supernatural grace upon your life. Come on, somebody shout, yes! In the kingdom, the will of God is done as it is done in heaven. Can I prophesy? You will not struggle to feed.
Amen.
Hey, people will struggle, but you will not struggle. I cancel struggle out of your life. Because you are in the kingdom, the kingdom. That kingdom, the kingdom has come. When Jesus shouted, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. When the temple, the partition, the wall of partition, tore into two. When God gave us access into his presence without any conditionalities, by virtue of the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary, that justified and sanctified me and made me pure before a holy God, by virtue of the atonement and the propitiation, by virtue of what Jesus did on the cross of Calvary, when he said it is finished, by virtue of my confession of Jesus as the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings, every struggle in my life is broken. Every clash in my life is broken. Every decision of the enemy against my life is broken, because the will of God is done in my life as it is done in heaven. And I prophesy over this church, from today you will walk as a kingdom citizen. You will walk as a kingdom citizen. Shout and receive it. Kingdom. Slap somebody and say kingdom.
Kingdom.
Say kingdom.
Kingdom.
My God, you will live in houses you have not built.
Amen.
Some of you, supernatural things are going to happen to you.
Amen.
Because the will of God, what's the will of God? The will of God is that you prosper.
Amen.
Now, I was checking scriptures, studying about kingdom. And I realized, you know, in the Garden of Eden, we lost our dominion. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
To the devil. The second Adam, Jesus came to restore back to us everything the devil had stolen. And so the reason God saved you is not just so you go to heaven. That's a done deal. It's like having a house and taking fire insurance is already secure. But then you must also walk in everything that God has promised you. There must be restoration of everything the devil has stolen. And that's why I believe that in this end time, people that are going to have this kingdom understanding are people who are going to break through. So that you understand that you cannot be limited by the economies of this world. You will not be limited by the things that kill other people. As a matter of fact, what killed other people will not kill you. Oh, I feel like the fire of God is burning all over this place. I feel that God is breaking chains. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but I sense the fire of God all over the place. Revival is about to break out. Something is about to happen. The kingdom of God is established in the minds and the hearts of people. Therefore, the will of God will be enforced in your life. Malaya, they come around and tell you, well, it's so difficult in this environment, you can't make it. Tell them, I will make it because my God is a faithful God.
Amen.
The kingdom of God be established. That means God's reign over the lives of people who enthrone him as a king. Now, I want to talk about two things here. Now, it is one thing for God to be a ruler, and it's another for you to enthrone him in your life as a ruler. He may be God, but if you are not submitted to his authority, he does not rule over you. And so the problems we have is that he is God, he is a ruler, he is a king, but we are not surrendered to his authority. I feel like talking to somebody here. We've not surrendered. We are not broken. We've not come to a place where we have completely surrendered to him. So we are minding our own business. But may we enthrone him in our lives. Let him become the king over your life. Am I talking to some people here? Let him become the ruler over your life. Let him become the ruler over your affairs. Because if you belong to the kingdom of God, then you must submit to the king. The only way by which his will be done in your will is when you as a subject is surrounded or submitted to the authority of the king. Praise the Lord. That's why we do what we do. Praise God. Because we have surrendered to the will of God. We have surrendered to his authority. Praise God. Can I prophesy upon you today? That as God liberates you from this religious mindset, you will begin to walk under the influence of God's kingdom.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lift up your hands and say, in the name of Jesus.
The name of Jesus.
Say, in the name of Jesus.
The name of Jesus.
I declare that my life, just say it as though
my life
shall be patterned according to the kingdom. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Look at your United Kingdom. Sometimes something small happens to you, all you have to do is to call. Now, how many of you know that you can have a situation in your home and there's provision, but if you don't call, the ambulances don't show up? Even though you have it in abundance in the United Kingdom. Praise God. Now some of you, God has made things abundantly available in the kingdom. but you've not picked up the phone to call 999. And so the ambulances are still waiting. The doctors are still waiting. That's why Jeremiah said, call upon me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you don't know. I prophesy to you that you will begin to activate the forces of the kingdom, because the Lord will be king over the earth and he is the Lord over the universe. And as a king, he has made everything available in his kingdom. And today healing is available. Today deliverance is available. Today miracles are available. My God, abundance of prosperity is coming your way. Somebody is going to look you up, look up to you, and then bless you, because in the kingdom of God, God's will shall be established. Praise the name of the Lord. Let thy kingdom come. Let thy will be done on earth as it is done in heaven. And the prayer you're going to pray, anything which does not look like the will of God in your life, must be broken, must be taken out of your life. Anything which does not resemble the will of God in your life, because as I read the Bible says, I wish above all things, that's my will above every other thing, is that you prosper. Amen. You know, if somebody told you that to be pure, you have to be broke, that's a lie. Amen. No, I see rich people in the house. I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospereth. And so your material prosperity, your financial prosperity is contingent on your soul prosperity or your spiritual prosperity. And that's why it said, even as. That means the condition for your soul, your body to prosper, and for you to prosper materially, is when your soul prospers. And the soul prosperity is what we call salvation. It's what we call submission to the authority of God. Amen. Your soul prospers. The more your soul prospers, the more you prosper physically. The more you prosper financially. Hey, doors will open for you unexpectedly. Because that's how the kingdom of God operates.
Amen.
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 I pray that we shall be a people who have surrendered to God's rulership.
Amen.
God's authority.
Amen.
See, one of the things that religion has done to us, that somebody said, religion, I bind you.
Religion, I bind you.
I said, that it's a religion, I bind you.
Religion,
I bind you. No, say it. It's a religion, I bind you.
Religion,
I'm telling you, religion can kill you. Religion can make you look so miserable, tattered, repulsive. It can make you look like an old, ancient, antiquated Homo sapiens. My God, some Christians behave like, oh, the problem of the whole world is on their head. My God, but in the kingdom there's liberation. For where the Spirit of God is, there's liberty. I hear freedom! And some of you, the yokes have been broken completely, because Jehovah God Almighty is liberating you. He is emancipating you. I hear freedom! Because in the kingdom of God, the will of God must be enforced.
Yes.
Freedom from poverty. Some of you, freedom from worry and anxiety. That's why I'm telling you that let the glory saturate your environment. Worry will not survive there. Because worry doesn't change anything. It keeps you busy. Worrying about what you can't change. I feel like talking to somebody here. I feel like, so some of you, God will deliver you. Some of you, at the moment something small happens, hey, and then you start Google, hey, cancer, the symptoms of cancer. Some of you, if I take your iPad and your phone, and I go to the Google history, yeah, the things you have Googled, only God knows the symptoms of acanabacoitis, the symptoms. Of things, but I prophesy in the kingdom of God, as you get such saturated in the glory of God, cancer cannot survive. Oh, I say cancer cannot survive because the will of God is enforced in the kingdom of God.
Yes, Lord.
Oh my God, it will have no place in your life. Poverty will have no place in your life. You will not die before your time. Anybody who came around to tell you you're going to die before your time, tell them, I have a God who has sustained me. I have a God who is bigger and greater than any demon, than any power. He says, I will not die, but I shall live to declare the words. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but may I prophesy over your life. In this kingdom, we don't die before our time. Is different. This kingdom operates differently. A week by this time, testimony is coming your way. My God, in this kingdom, you can look at the negative situation and say, this is not my portion. In this kingdom, everybody may be saying one thing, but they say, my God has not told me that, because it does not pertain in the kingdom where I'm a subject. Now some of us are so dysfunctional religiously in our mindset. We're listening to the multitude and what they are saying to us. Sometimes even the doctor can mislead you because he does the prognosis and diagnosis and then tell you that you're suffering from coccidiosis or some strange disease, and all of a sudden you begin to shake. But the Bible says, by the stripes of Jesus I am healed. That is what pertains in the kingdom of God. Am I talking to somebody here? And so you may tell me, I have a condition, by the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary and the beatings that Jesus received at his back made it possible for me to be healed in the kingdom that I belong to. Come on, somebody shout, yeah! Lift up your hands and let your will be done. It is done in heaven. Now look at heaven. Look at heaven. Just look at heaven. The angels walk on gold, or they fly on gold. Look at heaven. If the will of God must be done on earth as it's done in heaven, then some of you are not living in heaven yet. You are living in heaven so cool. But I prophesy over your life in the name of Jesus that the total will of God shall be enforced in your life. Bible says when we go, they will be walking on gold. Yes. That means that God is going to bless you so much. My God, that you will become a blessing. Because in the kingdom, this kingdom, read your Bible from Genesis to Revelation. Every day you see the fathers blessing the children. And they bless them anytime. Blessing comes upon them, because blessing is not what you have. As in terms of physical things, but it's what is only you that produces the physical things. Praise God. And so you see the fathers always releasing blessing upon the sons to go and prosper. And I see Jesus, the King of glory, empowering you. And that's why he said, you have been blessed with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. The Bible says we have also become the divine, the partakers of the divine nature. That's why in this kingdom, you are not dragged into it. You are not naturalized. You are born into it. Born again means you have been given birth to by God. It's different when I adopt you than when I give birth to you. Because you become my legitimate child. That means that your umbilical cord is connected to mine. That means what is mine is yours. That's why the Bible says we are joined heirs with Christ. That means that whatever belongs to Christ belongs to me. I don't know who I'm preaching to. So in this kingdom, whatever belongs to Jesus belongs to me. May we become a people of understanding who will walk in the will of God. Understanding that whatever belongs to Jesus is ours. Because the will of God must be done. We're going to pray. In heaven, on earth, as in heaven. So you're going to begin from now to look at heaven. There's nothing missing. There's nothing broken. I refuse to allow my present circumstances to determine my future. I refuse to look at the pain I'm going through to determine the direction of my life. I refuse to allow people and their opinion and their behavior to determine the course of my life. I am on course to be prosperous. I am on course to be great. I'm on course to have multiple breakthroughs on every side. I am on course that whatever I touch will prosper. Whatever the soles of my feet shall tread upon shall be given unto me for my inheritance. I see millionaires in the house. I see great men and women in the house because the kingdom of God has arrived and the will of God must be established in your life as it is done in heaven. Stand to your feet. We want to pray. 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 Come on, we want to pray. Lift up those hands. Lift up those hands. Give honor to God. Lift up those hands and begin to pray.